Is it choice that carries you here, or is it fate? I see a need in you. A need to peer into your future. A need to follow the right path. But your future has already been cast. So open your mind and embrace it. Long ago, my people called me a Hatungo, a wise woman. Now they call me a revenant. But it is not my fate to return to the Mother of Death just yet. For now, I stand with one foot in this world, and the other foot in the realm of the dead. I'm an inquirer of the living, and an interpreter of death. I sense you have questions. For a gift of silver, I will answer them. But you seek more than answers. Riches, power. These I can also provide, in a way. All you have to do is join me. Heed my words, but walk your path. The future is mine to tell, but yours to claim. It is time to fulfill your prophecy. Guidance is priced in silver. If the price is not paid, the stone will stay silent. Fate will find you.
Finally, come on. I need more mana.
The black spirit infects living flesh and bone. The animals suffered first, their bodies changed, their eyes filled with a hatred of mankind that is beyond instinct. Now it is time to bend and bow. howl like serpents before the seaborne gale. The firstborn of the Kingdom of Calm greeted us this day. The firstborn of the Kingdom of Calm was buried this day. Even our children are not spared the Black Spirit's touch. What have you done to enrage Rayquast? We look to Calm. Our king will lay the spirit of this man at peace.
And not before.
Need more mana. mana.
The Earth of Rayclast rejects the dead. The black spirit of storm and dream now reaches into the ground and raises up our slain Imperial foes. It meets the fallen from their graves and drives them to fight us beyond the end, rotten tooth and jagged nail. Our own remembered have joined their cursed ranks. No longer may we give our beloved to the birds, messengers of spirits, of flesh to the earth. Khan has commanded us to destroy our remembered with axe and fire. Khan is the bravest of us, willing to bear
it's
the ire
lucky
of the
day.
Ancestors for the survival of his people.
Still alive. Greetings. Farewell.
Again, local.
The black spirit infects living flesh. The black spirit infects.
I'm ready.
I'd rather burn than call such a place home.
It's my lucky day!
Ready and not full.
The tale of Brutus was a popular one in the schools of Theopolis, taught in the hopes of deterring students from ambitions not condoned by the Templar. Brutus was warden of Axiom Prison and one of the most feared men in the Eternal Empire. But there the histories end, and the myth begins, with Brutus commissioning a witch to transform him in a mad attempt at immortality. A moment of hubris that didn't end well for anyone. If it's true, then Brutus has my pity. Some of us pay too dearly for our mistakes. Yet if you insist on learning from your own mistakes, then please, take one of these. You might need it. God hasn't abandoned us.
There's a fine line between man and monster. Brutus, the warden of Axiom Prison, he crossed that line long ago. A big lad, and as you know from Hillock, big lads are slow. Hit and run, that's the way to cut them down to size. Unless there's thaumaturgy involved, then forget the hitting bit, just run. Farewell.
Hello. Take care.